Hello, my dear students. Good morning. Previously, we discussed about some important rules to calculate oxidation state for a particular atom. Okay. So, in that particular, I was given for elemental state atoms. In elemental state means free state for atoms, oxidation state will be zero, and oxidation state exists for any particular atom only in combined state. Means when it bonded with somebody else. Okay, so what will be the oxidation state? It can be positive, it can be negative, it can be fractional, it can be zero, I said. And one more important thing, in free state, oxidation state will be zero. Okay, for alkali metals, oxidation state is always plus one. I said alkaline earth metals, I said always plus two. Hydrogen exhibit either minus one or plus one, I said. And for halogens, I said actually minus 1 general oxidation state, because from 5th A I was given clearly oxidation state from 5th A it is equals to group number minus 8 actually. Okay, and for less means up to 4A group elements, oxidation state is equals to group number that we discussed in periodic table. So hydrogen oxidation state over, afterwards halogen oxidation state. I said halogen in that general oxidation state is minus 1. And afterwards, I said for fluorine always minus 1, I said, and remaining halogens can have positive oxidation states, I said. And afterwards, I said like chlorine exhibit plus 1, plus 2, I mean plus 3, plus 5, plus 7 also possible in some oxides. We will have further examples. See, I said one more important thing is that electronegativity values are very important to understand oxidation states. Element which have more electronegativity that will have negative oxidation state, and element which have less electronegativity that will have positive oxidation state. This is clear. And as I mentioned already, suppose chlorine with hydrogen, chlorine minus 1, because chlorine is more electronegative than hydrogen, that is the reason. And chlorine with oxygen, I was given example also like Cl2O there. So here oxygen is more electronegative, so chlorine is positive there. Chlorine is positive when oxygen are present actually. Oxygen is more electronegative, its electronegativity value is 3.5. So oxygen have a minus 2, I said, and here therefore each chlorine has plus 1, I said. So in this way I was given oxidation states. And more importantly, I was given oxidation state of oxygen. Oxygen general oxidation state is minus 2, because general oxidation state for elements greater than 4A means from 5th A it is group number minus 8. Oxygen is 6th A, so 6 minus 8 minus 2, so oxygen general oxidation state is minus 2. But oxygen exists in three ways, I said. One is oxide, peroxide and superoxide. Oxide means minus 2. Oxide, I was given double bond O if there, that is oxide, then oxidation state is minus 2, I said. Oxygen with the OH in the form of OH, then also oxygen minus 2, I said. In this way. And one more important thing is oxygen when it is like this, OO, then it's called peroxy. In this kind. How to have, I was given some examples. Their oxidation states, how to have, I was given some examples in previous. So when oxygen is, two oxygens are single bonded like this, then that is called peroxy bond. Hydrogen peroxide means HOOH like this. So here two oxygens are in single bonded, so this is called peroxide. In this way, I was given one more, that is superoxide, in which oxidation state of oxygen is minus half. Till that we discussed in previous. Now come to today's class, just like small recap. Okay, so here one important thing is charge on cation or anion is equal to oxidation state of the particular cation or anion actually. So I repeat this point, charge what we have on cation or anion is equal to oxidation state of that particular group. Group means that particular cation or anion. Suppose I was given here some cations example, and here I was given some anions examples. So cations means everybody knows positive ions. I written before only, so to save some time. So here if you see this ammonium NH4 group, okay, so the whole group has plus one charge here, not for nitrogen, not for hydrogen. This is the positive charge of a whole group actually. So cations mostly we have with some metals. So Az plus, so plus 1, Zn, so plus 2, aluminium plus 3, iron, ferrous, ferric, like this. So how to have these oxidation state in molecules? Then we must know anions, because these metals always with anions or not, because metals are forming cations. So cations always with anions. So to know the charges of Mr. Metals, you must know the charges of anions. So this part is very, very important actually. This part is more important. Here if you see some anions, it's called nitrite. In previous also I think I was given NO2 minus. This is the charge. Okay, NO2 charge is minus 1. NO3 charge is minus 1. Bicarbonate minus 1. Bisulfate minus 1. And bisulfite. See, bisulfite HSO3 minus. CN minus cyanide. Isocyanide, NC minus is isocyanide, that's different. Here nitrogen bonded with some other, here carbon will be bonded with some another atom actually. Okay, so carbon bonded, then cyanide, nitrogen bonded, then that is called isocyanide. So both have, these all have minus one charge only, these all have minus one charge. So for all these groups, what is the charge means? Minus 1. Okay, so here CO3 minus 2 and here SO4 minus 2. Here for this kind, minus 2 is the charge. Okay, even like SO3 minus 2 you have like that. Okay, some ions like oxalate, COO minus and COO minus. So oxalate, simply we call C2O4 minus 2 or else C2O4 minus 2, which is called oxalate. Understanding everyone? So here sulfite, sulfate, you write down names. This is sulfite and this is sulfate and this is carbonate. For all these you have charge minus 2. For whole group means CO3 group has minus 2 charge. Hope you understood. And this kind PO4 minus 3 and this has minus 3 charge. So the group has particular charge. That charge is the oxidation state of that particular whole group. Understood? So this is anion. Anion, this anion charge or oxidation state is how much means? This charge what we have is equal to oxidation state of this group. Got it what I am saying? So PO4 minus 3. So for entire group, the charge what we have minus 3. This minus 3 is the oxidation state for this entire group. Suppose if I have like NH4 twice SO4. It's very clear. NH4, what is the charge? NH4 plus and SO4 charge is what I said, SO4 minus 2. So SO4 minus 2 here. Okay, so the entire SO4 has minus 2 charge. So the it should be neutralized. It's a salt. Salt means neutral or not, tell me. So what the anion charge you have, the same amount of charge should be present for cation. So what is the cation here? NH4 plus. So the cation is what? NH4 plus. So how many NH4 plus should be present? 2. Because one NH4 has plus 1 ammonium. So 2 NH4 plus means plus 2 here, charge, total charge. So total minus 2 and here, sorry, minus 2 plus 2, cancel. Got it? Like that, suppose Cr2O3 like this. This is oxide, no problem. And here suppose FeSO4, okay. And here Fe2SO4 thrice. So sulfate charge everybody knows. Here chromium is only when oxygen is there, one oxygen is there, this is called oxide, then oxygen has minus 2. How many chromiums are there? 2, so 2x plus 3 into minus 2 is equal to 0. Why it took understood? Because this is a neutral molecule. So oxygen, general oxidation state we have to take when that is oxide. Getting what I am saying? So Cr2O3, here chromium oxidation state we don't know. So oxygen we know. Alkali metals and alkaline earth metals means we know. Alkali metal is there with oxygen. Okay, no need to say alkali metal always plus 1. Alkaline earth metal always plus 2. But chromium, iron, these are transition metals. They exhibit more than one kind of oxidation states. So, based on the particular atoms who are attached to these metals, from those we have to say oxidation states of these metals. Because these metals exhibiting more than one oxidation state. They are called transition metals. Transition elements properties I was given. Okay, variable valences they exhibit. Variable means, what is the meaning? More than one oxidation state they exhibit. So here chromium is what? 2x is equals to plus 6. Then x equal to plus 3. Hope you understood. So what I am saying, understanding? From the anions, we are deciding the oxidation state of these metals. But for alkali metals and alkaline earth metals, we have no need to calculate, because alkali metals always plus 1, alkaline earth metals always plus 2. But to come to these transition metals, means which are present in D block, we have to decide their oxidation states with the beside groups, what we have. So here we have iron. So here also we have iron. Then what's the difference between these two? So we will decide from sulfate. The whole sulfate has minus 2, I said already. Okay, so iron is x, x plus of minus 2. This was salt, so equal to 0, no charge on it. So x equal to plus 2 here. But whereas here, how many irons are there? 2 irons are there, right? So 2x I have to take. Here why I took only x? Because one iron is there. Here why I took 2x? Because 2 irons are there. Okay, so 2x plus 3 into minus 2 is equals to 0. Then 2x equal to plus 6. Then x equal to plus 3. What is the difference? Here you identify means, here iron have plus 2 oxidation state. Here iron have plus 3 oxidation state. So this is called ferrous. How we decided? We decided from anion. Okay. So here this is called ferric. So which has more oxidation state, that we call ic. Ic, hic, more. Okay. So ferric plus 3. Ferrous plus 2 there. Here chromium just normal I was given example. Because some examples are like this Cr2O3 here. Okay, Cr2O7 minus 2 is there suppose. Here, see the chromium oxidation state will change. That's why I given these examples. Here how many chromiums are there? So 2x. 2 chromiums are there, right? And 7. 7 into minus 2 is equal to minus 2. So why equal to minus 2 I took this time? Here I was taken equal to 0. Here equal to minus 2 I was taken. What is the reason behind it? Means only one reason. Here this is not neutral. Here you have a charge minus 2. So that charge we have to take equal. Understanding? Cr2O7 minus 2. It's anion. It is not a molecule. It's just anion. So in anion, I want chromium oxidation state suddenly. The whole Cr2O7 has minus 2 charge. So that I was taken as equal to minus 2. So here what I have means 2x plus 4, 2x minus 14 is equal to minus 2. So that 2x equal to plus 12, then x equal to plus 6. You identified. Chromium has different oxidation state. Here iron has different oxidation state. So that's why I given this example now. So what exact point here we discussed means, charge on cation or anion is equal to oxidation state of the particular cation or anion we have to consider. Is it clear? So for cations, these are some examples I was given, and these are the anions with some examples. Okay, with their charges I was given. So uninegative charge, binegative. Okay, so uninegative. So here minus 2, here minus 3. Like that, we have some cations and anions. Now let's see some examples. How to calculate oxidation state? Okay, so it's very clear. What is that? If neutral molecule given, then first for whom you have to calculate oxidation state, consider as X, and that X, 2X, 3X depends on the number of atoms and the terminal atoms oxidation state, and equal to 0 when we will take, when the neutral molecule given, equal to 0 we will take. If some charge is there, that charge we will take. That's it. Okay. So for whom we will calculate oxidation state, please have a screenshot. I forgot to give you that. Okay. Here what I given? NH4 twice I given. I think NH4 twice SO4 I was given. So here I said 2NH4 plus and SO4 minus 2. So each NH4 has plus 1. So total is plus 2. Okay, so total is 2 into plus 1. Okay, that means here plus 2 have, and here sulfate is minus 2. The total is cancel, I said. Okay, have a screenshot and write all notes. Notes is very, very important. Okay, so everybody please make a note, all these things. Okay, very, very important. So all rules we discussed. Now what we will do? Now we will calculate some oxidation states for some examples. Okay, for atoms we will calculate actually. Oxalate, do you remember? Oxalate, what is oxalate? C2O4 minus 2, that is oxalate. C2O4 minus 2. Okay, there minus 2 is the carbonate, means what? CO3 minus 2. Understood? Sulfate, SO4 minus 2. Sulfide, SO3 minus 2, like that. Okay, now I will give some examples how to write, how to calculate oxidation states. Let's see now. Okay, suppose here I was, I will write now, neutral molecule I am writing now. Neutral molecule. For a neutral molecule, what we will do? Very simple. For atom which we will calculate oxidation state, that we will take X. X, 2X, that depends on what? Number of atoms. Okay. Calculation of oxidation states in neutral molecules. So for whom, the atom for whom you will calculate oxidation state, that you consider X. Okay, sir. And X plus charges or oxidation states of remaining atoms. Remaining atoms is equal to 0. Okay. X into some number otherwise. What is this number? If two atoms are there, in previous two chromiums means 2X we taken like that. N can be 1. Okay. So oxidation states of remaining atoms, okay, who are bonded with this X, and equal to 0, why we taken? Because we are calculating oxidation state of atom in neutral molecule. Suppose if we are calculating oxidation state of atom in anion, in what, sir? Anion. Previously I was given some example. How I'll take same N into X. Okay. N into X plus oxidation states of remaining atoms is equal to charge on it. Simply what you can write? Charge on it. See, if it is anion, negative charge. If it is cation, you will take positive charge. That's it. Understood? So charge on it we have to consider. Okay, n into x. What is n? Number of atoms. N is what? Number of atoms. Okay, and if anion, the charge on it I have written. What is the charge here? If it is positive or negative charge. If it is anion, negative charge you will take here. If it is cation, here we will take positive charge. That's it. Sir, understood everyone? Okay. Oxidation state of atom in anion or cation, how to take means? We have to take equal to the charge on it. If it is cation, equal to positive charge. Okay. If negative charge, if it is anion, we will consider negative charge here. That's it. I will give you examples. And before that, some neutral molecules also can be present. For neutral molecules like NH3, okay, water, CO. For these whole molecules, for these are molecules now. So for these molecules, oxidation states will be zero. Getting what I'm saying? Here ammonia is in a complex. In complex when these neutral molecules are there. Complex means big molecules. So in bulky molecules or in big molecules, if these are the molecules present like ammonia, water, CO, then for these molecules oxidation states we have to consider zero. This is very very important. In complex compounds, actually complex compounds we have one chapter in second year. They are very much useful. In those complex compounds, these are called neutral ligands. Simply now remember that word we won't use now. For these molecules, in those complex molecules, we will take oxidation states as zero. This part you remember, that's it. Okay, like see here NiCO4 times. Like this they give molecule. Suppose, what is this? Here, nickel bonded with CO. How many COs are there? 4. Okay, this CO. CO means what? Neutral, carbonyl. What is CO? Water, this is ammonia, you know. Water, you know. This is called carbonyl. They give like this. What is the oxidation state of nickel, they will ask. Then, you have to take nickel X. Is there any charge on it? No charge. If charge is there, how we can come to know, sir? They will mention charge. Don't worry. Okay. So, neutral molecules means equal to 0, you have to take as a. First, you have to take X. N value is 1 here. Because 1 nickel only there. X plus 4 into 0 is equal to 0. Why is equal to 0? Because no charge in it. So, this nickel oxidation state is 0. Because the whole CO has 0 oxidation state. This is one of the important example. Okay. Suppose, see, CO NH3 6 times. Here, plus 3 is there. Like this. CO NH3 6 times plus 3 given and asking what is the cobalt oxidation state. Okay, here whole complex, this is called complex. Okay, complex we use square bracket. Remember that much only here, don't get confused. This CO, this is carbon monoxide, don't think. CO, here this is carbonyl and this is cobalt. When small O written, like this, cobalt. Capital O written, carbonyl. Don't get confused. Okay, sir? So now, this is cobalt. Here, CO, carbonyl. Capital O. Okay, oxygen that is. Here, CO, cobalt. So, here, what is the cobalt oxidation state? I'm taking again X. This is ammonia. Ammonia is 0. So, X plus 6 into 0 is equal to, what I said here, for cation or anion, X, one number only you have cobalt, so 1 into X, and oxidation states of remaining atoms or groups. Here ammonia is a group you have. 6 ammonias are there, that's why. Okay, sincerely I written 6 now. First 6 I have. So ammonia is a neutral, as I said. So ammonia oxidation state is 0. Okay, so x plus 6 equal to 0. Now equal to 0 I have to take a plus 3 R, means charge on it. I said charge on it. What do you have here? Plus 3. So you have to take plus 3. Few people are very smart. Sir, charge on it, sir. Very good, sir. Your power 1 is there. Take 1. Charge on it means for neutral molecules equal to 0 we will take. This is like a neutral molecule. No charge on it. That's the meaning. So nothing is there means power 1 is there. No, sir. Few people will say. No, that is not correct. Here it's a neutral molecule, so equal to 0. Hope you understood. Okay. Now, this also you understood, I think so. X. Cobalt is X. 6 ammonias are there. 6. Ammonia is a neutral, its oxidation state is 0. So I took 6 into 0 is equal to plus 3. So then what I have here means x equal to plus 3, that's it. Got it? Another example I will give now. One more example. K4FeCN6 times. What do you have here? Potassium ferrocyanide. Names also we will discuss. K4FeCN6 times. Here I want iron oxidation state. Names we won't discuss right now. In complex compounds, these are all names, IUPAC, names of complex compounds, we will discuss there. Now simply concentrate how to calculate oxidation state of iron there. Because potassium well known, alkali metal, it's plus 1. So we have no need to calculate. Cyanide we know, Cn minus, I have told you in previous anions example I was given. There cyanide I was given minus 1. So minus 1 is a cyanide. Then whose oxidation state is unknown means iron. So iron no, we know no sir, plus 2, plus 3. It can exhibit plus 2, plus 3 and some fractional also, because that is transition metal. So we have to calculate iron oxidation state. I am considering as X again. What did everyone? So iron oxidation state I am considering as X plus. How many potassiums are there? Those many. Because charges of all remaining atoms I have to consider. For whom you are calculating for that X, remaining all we have to consider. Okay, we have to consider, sorry. So 4 potassiums are there, 4 into plus 1, plus 6 into minus 1 equal to 0. This please note carefully. Okay, please try to understand everyone. Iron oxidation state is X and potassiums are 4, 4 into plus 1. And cyanides are 6. So 6 into minus 1. Because in previous I said Cn minus. So this negative charge is the charge of this cyanide. What sir? Negative charge is the charge. This negative charge is the oxidation state of whole Cn. So 6 cyanides are there. So 6 I written. Each cyanide is minus 1. So 6 into minus 1 equal to 0. Then X plus 4 minus 6 equal to 0. Then X equal to plus 2. Here iron oxidation state is plus 2. Understood everyone? So in this way you can have oxidation states of any particular atom by considering X. X or Y. So Y X means simply commonly everybody will use X. You also use the same. Sir, X, 2X, 3X, how we decide means based on the molecule. Suppose, if I ask oxidation state of K2Cr2O7, I want oxidation state of chromium. In all these kind, you remember oxygen is minus 2. In oxides, if there was not used peroxide name like that, then we have to take it is oxide. Means oxygen have minus 2 oxidation state we have to consider. In this example, if I want chromium oxidation state, potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7 have to consider 2x. 2x plus, how many potassiums are there? 2. 2 into plus 1. Why I took 2x here? Why I took here iron x only? Because 1 iron is there. Here nickel I took only x because 1 nickel is there. Here I want underlying atom oxidation state I want. How many chromiums are there? 2. 2x. How many potassiums are there? 2. Alkali metal na potassium? So it's plus 1. 7 into minus 2 equal to 0 I have taken this time. Difference understood? In previous Cr2O7 minus 2 I was taken. You written I think so. Cr equal to minus 2 I taken. But here potassium is there. So this is a neutral molecule. So here equal to 0 I have taken. Difference understand? Very simple. Then 2x equal to just plus 12 you get. That implies x equal to plus 6. That means chromium oxidation state you are getting plus 6 like this. Okay. In this way you can have oxidation states. Okay. Later on we will discuss few more oxidation states. Okay sir.